Spindle cell lipomas tend to affect elderly males. The usual location is the upper back, back of neck, and shoulders. Less frequently, they can occur on the face, the orbit, and the oral cavity. They are generally solitary, slow-growing tumours, 5 centimetres or less in diameter. Grossly, they are well circumscribed, have a rather paler and firmer cut surface than conventional lipomas because of the fibrous component, and they are composed of a mixture of adipocytes and spindle cells that are in varying proportions, and in some cases there may be virtually no adipocytes present, which can make the diagnosis really quite difficult. In addition, there is often a mucinous matrix, and another feature is the presence of numerous mast cells. Here is a low-power view of a spindle cell lipoma with a fairly equal mix of spindle cells and adipocytes. And in this area you can see the rather mucoid matrix of the spindle cell lipoma. And in this spindle cell lipoma, towards the left of the picture, the tumour is composed almost exclusively of spindle cells, but as we move towards the right side, more and more adipocytes come into view, revealing the true nature of the tumour.